So today we are going to see how to use this digital level to determine the reduced levels of the different points. So before going to that task, let me tell you how to do the temporary adjustments of this digital level. So first thing is a fixing of your tripod stand. So before going to this, let me tell you, let us assume that we are going to find out the reduced levels of 5 to 6 points. Okay, so sir, can you show this point? So a few points on this ground, okay, then a few points on this side, okay, and a few points on that side. So we are going to cover this area to take the staff reading or to find out the reduced levels of 5 to 6 points. Okay, so I have selected a station in such a way that all the points are visible from this station. Okay, all the points are visible from this station. This is the criteria for the fixing of this digital level station. So this is the tripod stand. So make sure that the legs of this tripod stand are veils frayed and firmly fixed on the ground. Okay, it should be firmly fixed on the ground so that your digital level is not going to disturb throughout the leveling activity. Then try to make the base of the tripod stand approximately horizontal. So I have made it horizontal. Okay, then clamp the tripod stand adjustment screw. The next step is to fix the digital level. So I am fixing with the tripod stand. So the fixing of a digital level. Now comes the leveling of the digital level. So for that purpose we are going to follow a certain procedure. So with that procedure you can do the leveling of a digital level. So first step is to make your telescope. So this is my telescope. This is the object glass. On this side, this is my eyepiece. So this is my telescope. So keep your telescope parallel to any foot screw. Okay, keep a telescope parallel to any one foot screw. You can fix your telescope parallel to this screw, or this screw, or this screw, any one. Okay, so I am making parallel to this foot screw. Okay, then sir, please. Okay, then by using the another two foot screws, okay, I have made a telescope parallel to this foot screw. Okay, then by using remaining two foot screw, we are going to bring the bubble somewhere here or here, which is parallel to my telescope, here or here. Okay, so let me do that first. Okay, now this bubble is parallel to my telescope. Now this bubble is parallel to my telescope. Okay, this bubble is parallel to a telescope. Okay, once it is a parallel, so you will see that bubble will be either here or here. When I move this two foot screws, this will go somewhere here or here. Then with the help of third foot screw, just push back to the center. No need to move the digital level at the same from the same location, just move towards the center. So this is the very simple procedure that you can follow to do the leveling of a digital level. Now let us see what steps we need to follow. I will show you some basic steps that we need to follow on every new station. Means this is my starting station. Okay, this is my starting station. So whatever the steps which I'm going to follow, that steps you need to follow whenever you are doing a change point. Okay, so same steps we are going to follow for the change point also. So this is my start station. At the start station, what points need to be followed, that we will see. So this is a benchmark. Okay, the person holding a barcoded staff, that is our benchmark, and the reduced level of that benchmark is, let us assume, the 100. Okay, and the point ID of that benchmark, let us assume that as a BM1. The BM1 is a point ID of that benchmark, that is the first benchmark, so BM1, and the reduced level of that benchmark is a 100. Okay, now before starting the actual leveling with the help of digital level, a certain steps need to be followed, and after that this equipment will give you the direct reduced levels of the different point. So for that purpose we need to first press this delta H button. Okay, press the delta H button. So when you press the delta H button, this screen will give you some message, that is reference point ID. Okay, a reference point ID is a C2BM. So this is one reference point ID is given. The reduced level of reference point is given as 100. It is already given as 100, but let us assume we will change this benchmark to 200, so that you will understand how to change the reduced level of a benchmark also. So I'll make it 200 right now. So this is the screen when you press the delta H. So first step is to press delta H, then you will find this screen. Now reference point ID I want to change. Okay, the reference point ID is BM1 in our case. So I'll go to the menu. In menu, go to the point input point ID, then press enter or menu button again, then change it to a BM. So I'm changing to BM. So to move cursor to the next point, just press enter button. I'm changing it BM1. So I need a BM1, so I'm making it BM1. So BM1. Now you can see the reference point ID has a BM1. Now it is changed to BM1. Now next step is to change the reduced level of your benchmark. Then again press menu button, then go to the input RL, press enter button and change to 200. Okay, I have changed. Just press up and down key to change the numbers. Okay, and to go to the next point, you can press the enter button. So in our case, we have assumed that the benchmark of our reduced level of a benchmark one is a 200. So I have set it to the 200. Now it is 200. Now you can see the reference point ID BM1, the reduced level as a 200. The both things are changed. Now after doing this step, you need to sight towards the benchmark. You need to sight towards the benchmark, and after sighting towards the benchmark, you need to press this tracking button, this rate tracking button. So I'll do that and just have a look on that. Okay. So use this target shoot first. Okay, use this target shoot first to sight towards the benchmark or any point. So this will help you to approximately bisect your staff. So first look through the target shoot. Once you look through the target shoot, then look through the telescope. Focus the telescope. Okay, focus the telescope, exactly bring your staff at the center of crosshairs. Okay, exactly bring the telescope on the staff. So crosshair must be at the center of your staff. Oh, okay, now it is perfectly focused. Okay, perfectly focused. Then now I'll press the tracking button. Okay, I'll press the tracking button. You just observe the screen. So it is tracking.
just it is saying invalid measurement. Why it is saying invalid measurement? Because now the staff is moved from the telescope range, so that's why it is saying invalid measurement. So I need to cite once again. Just so once again we have focused towards the benchmark, okay, and now we will press the tracking button, okay. So just have a look on the screen so that you will see what is happening. So I have pressed again, it is showing invalid measurement. Sir, please don't move the staff. Okay, I am pressing. So whenever staff goes out of the screen, it will show the invalid measurement. So I am again pressing the tracking button. Now it is showing the benchmark staff reading. It was showing the benchmark staff reading and the horizontal distance between the station and the benchmark. Now it is saying major target once again. So again press the tracking button. So I am pressing the tracking button once again. Now it will show you the BM as a point ID, the reduced level of benchmark as a 200, delta H is the difference between the benchmark and the point. In our case, as we have taken the first point on a benchmark, there will not be any difference, so it is 0. Staff reading is 1.296 and the horizontal distance between the equipment station and the staff is a 20.91. So this data we are going to get from the digital level. Focus on this point to get the reduced level of that point. So I have focused on that point. Okay, now I'll press the tracking button and let us see what is the reading. Okay, now the point ID is changed. Okay, the reduced level of this point is a 200.418 and difference delta H is 0.418. So this is the difference in a or difference with respect to the benchmark, that is 0.418. Staff reading is a 0.877 and 32 meter approximately it is a horizontal distance. Stop. So we'll try to find out the reduced level of one more point, and that is the point whose RL we are going to find out. So again focus towards the point. Okay, then do the perfect focusing, exactly bisect on the staff, and again press the tracking button. Okay, again press the tracking button and see the what change is happening. Okay, now the reduced level is changed to 200.598 and the point ID is automatically changed. Okay, so this is delta H, staff reading, and this is the horizontal distance. Okay, so this is the data of the point 3. Okay, now let us assume that from this point, or this is the last point of this set. Okay, after this point the other points are not visible, so we are going to do a change point. So let us have a change point and then we will see what procedure need to be followed on a change point. So that is the last point. So whenever you are taking a reading on a last point, you need to note down the point ID of the last point, that is BM3. So I am noting down the BM3 is my last point, and the reduced level of that last point is a 200.598. So just take a note of these two things, because for the next set, the last point of first set will be the reference ID. So I need this data. So that's why I have noted down the information. Okay. Now we have moved to the next station. So on this station also we are going to do the temporary adjustment. Whatever we have just seen in the start of the video, the same temporary adjustment already done. Then we are going to take a first reading on the last point of the first set. So for that purpose again we are going to do the same steps, that is pressing a delta H, pressing a delta H. So I'll press the delta H first. So on every change point we are going to repeat the same procedure. So So press delta H. So I'm pressing the delta H. Now the point ID of a last point is a BM3. So I need to change the reference point ID as well as reference point ID's reduce level. So I'll go to the menu. Okay, in a menu I'll change the point ID to the reference point ID as a BM3. Okay, then again I'll go to the menu, input RL. Next step is input point RL. So we are going to give the reduced level of the last point of a first set. So for that purpose, press menu, go to the input RL, then press enter button. Okay, and then change the reference RL, that is a 200.598. So I'll make it 200.598. Okay, now it is changed to 200.598. Now sight towards the last point of the first set. Okay, I'm going to sight towards the last point of first set. Okay, come. Oh my goodness. Now we'll press the tracking button once again. So just see the staff reading and the horizontal distance. Again, it will say the major target. Again, press the tracking button. So now the point ID is changed to BM3. Now you will see the reduced level. We have entered 200.598. Now it is slightly changed because of movement of the staff. Okay, and delta H is showing 0.001 meter difference. Otherwise, it will not show any difference. Okay, this is a new point. Okay, this is a new point whose RL we are going to find out. So I'll move my telescope towards this new point. Then perfectly bisect the focusing and then just press the tracking button once again. So you will get the reduced level of that point. I'm pressing the tracking button. So now BM5 and the reduced level of that point is a 200.984, and this is the delta H difference. Okay, then staff reading and the horizontal distance. So these details we will get. So this is a very simple procedure that we need to follow to get the reduced levels of a different points using a digital level. So thank you, students.